गौरव आर यू देयर?
यस मैम आई एम हियर।
सो शिवदयाल सर हैज जॉइंड अस और ही विल टेक सम टाइम।
I think Jay has dropped a mail and he will join.
Okay.
Thank you. think sir has joined the meeting.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning. मैम आवाज आ रही है मेरी?
जी सर आवाज आ रही है.
गुड मॉर्निंग सर. गुड
मॉर्निंग सर.
गुड मॉर्निंग. गुड मॉर्निंग.
सो गौरव प्लीज इंट्रोड्यूस टू सर टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स.
यस यस मैम. गुड मॉर्निंग सर. आई एम गौरव कसेरा एंड आई एम वन ऑफ द मॉडरेटर्स ऑफ दिस मीट. एंड सर लेट मी टेक द प्रिविलेज ऑफ इंट्रोड्यूसिंग यू टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स. Dr. Shivdayal sir, Dr. Shivdayal Patel sir is currently working as an assistant professor in the mechanical engineering in Indian Institute of Information and Technology Design and Manufacturing, Jabalpur. Sir has completed his bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering at Sri Govindaram Siksaria Institute of Technology and Science, Indore in 2008. Sir completed his master's degree in mechanical engineering at Maulana Azad National Institute of Technology, Bhopal in 2010. And he's completed his PhD in Applied Mechanics Department at Indian Institute of Technology, Delhi, in 2016. Sir joined Institute of Superior Technico, Lisbon, Portugal, for probabilistic design of offshore structures in Portugal as an postdoctoral scientist in 2016. Sir has 27 publications in May, national and international journals. Sir is also recipient several awards such as Best M.Tech Thesis Silver Medal Award and 4 times Best Research Paper in 3 different conferences. Sir, it's an honor to have you between us for this session without wasting much of our time, and I would like to give you the platform to start your prestigious session. Sir, the stage is yours.
Thank you, Guru.
You're welcome.
मेरी स्लाइड दिख रही है आपको?
यस सर इट्स विजिबल.
He has given me a opportunity to share my knowledge and experience on LAN FDP on finite element methods. My topic of presentation is the finite element analysis of structural dynamics. So good morning all of you. Madam, should I start?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So first, we know what is the static analysis and dynamic. Actually, today I want to give a small introduction about the static analysis and dynamic analysis. So first we should know what is the static analysis. As you know, now if you are using different type of software such as the ANSYS, Abaqus, so now in ANSYS software, first is come ki what type of analysis you have to perform, static analysis or dynamic analysis or thermal analysis or electromechanical analysis. So first we should know ki what type of analysis we want to perform, what type of physical problem you want to solve using the finite element method. So in finite element analysis, first we should know ki what type of loading are acting your physical system. Such as the static analysis, we are consider the load are constant with respect to time. If load is constant with respect to time, then we should know ki we are performing the static analysis. Now if load are varying with respect to time, such as the harmonic loading or periodic loading or some impulsive loading, then we perform the finite element analysis. Dynamic analysis we have performed based on different types of methods, such as the implicit method or explicit methods. Or so first we should know ki what are the different components are come in static analysis or dynamic analysis. So in static analysis we are using the equilibrium equation, that is a simple equilibrium equation, that is F equal to kx. Now if we are performing the dynamic analysis, then and are come under the inertia force and also consider the damping force. So first we should know what is the dynamics. The word dynamic simply means the change in with time. Now if forcing function with change with respect to time, so then it's known as the dynamic analysis. So this is the one diagram are shown in here, the static loading. Now if the force are now see here the force are varying with respect to time. F0 is changing with respect to time. So now if loading pattern are changing with respect to time, so then is the dynamic loading, or we have to perform the dynamic analysis. So this is the some example. Now if beam are acting the some concentrated load with respect to time are varying. So now if first diagram is shown, if load are in any pinpoint, the constant load are applying in beam. So this is the static analysis. Now if load are changing with respect to time, so this is the dynamic analysis. Now so here the resistance due to the internal elastic force of structure are acting. Now if load are changing with respect to time, then acceleration producing the some inertia forces. So what are the output we have considered? Now in the static analysis we have output the resistance due to the static loading is displacement are considered.
Sorry to interrupt you, but I think your slides are not changing. We are seeing only the introduction slide.
Okay.
Sir, please change your slide in the PPT mode. The participants are requesting it is not visible to them.
And sir, please use slideshow mode. Slideshow mode.
Slide.
Yes, sir. Slideshow mode. Then it will be more clear to participants.
Sir, there is a slideshow tab above there.
मैडम अब आ रहा है?
नहीं सर, अभी तो कुछ भी विजिबल नहीं है.
सर, योर स्क्रीन इज नॉट शेयर्ड. Okay, sir. Now it's visible.
This is like what is dynamic that is showing?
Yes.
Okay. So this is the static and dynamic. This is when two examples here. The basic difference between the static and dynamic loading. Now, if this is the beam, if load are constant are acting in the beam. So this is the static analysis. Now if load are changing with respect to time, so this is the dynamic loading. Static analysis, the internal elastic forces are acting on the structure. Now if we are considering the dynamic loading, then acceleration also produces the inertia forces, and we also consider the dynamic the damping forces. Now under the output, what are we are expected to determine the static analysis, the resistance due to the static loading is a displacement or stress at a particular time, instance, what is the stress. Now under the dynamic analysis, we are find out the output, the dynamic loading, the displacement, velocity or acceleration. So under the static analysis, the structure is time dependent if the loading is time dependent. Now, however, if the loading are cyclic or frequency less than the roughly the 1/4 of the structure, then the lowest natural frequency of the vibration. So this is how we have to go. This is the static analysis or this is the dynamic analysis. Now, if dynamic response, we are also used if the hardly the larger the static response is the greater than the 7% of the single degree of freedom system we are considering. So under the dynamic analysis, basically we have to calculate the natural frequency, eigenvalue or eigenvector, and the frequency and shifts must be known in the order. To use the some methods, the dynamic response analysis, the application may seek the design at the natural frequency as well the separate the home frequency and applied loading. To calculate the frequency and mode, we solve the eigenvalue problem, and which is the algebraic form of that appear the buckling analysis. So this is the, now if the loading are harmonic, then we are also consider this is the analysis of the dynamic analysis or transient analysis or steady state analysis. So this is if the load are sometime is not periodic, is a random loading, so that is also come under the dynamic analysis. So these are some example ki how, what are the dynamic analysis, how to solve this type of problem. So first we should know what is the static analysis. So static analysis of bar, I think you are already studied in previous sessions. So I will give a small introduction about the static analysis ki how to we have to determine the case stiffness matrix. There are different types of method, the equilibrium method, energy methods. So first we have to assume some assumptions ki we are consider here the elastic deformation, the small deformation, elastic material, static loading. Because we are here consider only the up to the elastic limit, we don't go the plastic deformation part, such as these are variation or these are the equations are valid only up to the elastic limit. So first we know okay, this is the bar elements. Now if bar are subjected to some external forces, these are the two nodes I and J. Now if J nodes are acting the external force Fj, due to the external force, the displacements are offered in this bar is the Uj. This is the due to the external force of Fi, the displacements are come Ui. So this is the bar elements we are considered the length of L, the cross section of area A is the modulus displacement or strain, or this is the stresses. So first we should know the strain displacement relation. The strain is the du upon dx, and stress or strain relation are come the sigma equal to E into strain. So first we should know now if we are applying here the equilibrium methods. So what is the equation? If I want to apply in any nodes, such as the I nodes, ith node or jth node, so first we know what is the equilibrium equation. In the static case is F equal to Ks. So here the, now if I want to apply the equation F, here only jth nodes. So jth node, the equation, the equilibrium equation F equal to the static case F equal to K into delta X. So now if I want to apply under the equilibrium condition, if jth node, so then fj equal to the k is the stiffness of that bar, delta x is the displacement. So here the uj is the displacement for the jth node, or ui is the displacement of the ith node. So here the delta x is come under the uj minus ui. So here we are consider the uj is the displacement, uj is greater than ui. So this is the simple equilibrium equation for the jth node, so the fj equal to k into uj minus ui. So under the equilibrium condition, so this is the first equation. Now if I want to apply the second equation for the ith nodes, then fi equal to ith nodes, the equation of motion. So here the, now here we are consider the force, but the under the equilibrium condition, the now if jth node the force are acting in this direction, then the under the equilibrium condition the ith node the force are acting just opposite direction, then this bar is under the equilibrium condition. So here the fi comes under the minus muj. Now if this is the equation number one, this is equation number two. Now if you are combined both equation, the equation number one in two in the vector form, so this is the fi, this is fj, or this equation is come in form of minus k minus k, this is the displacement vector ui or u minus j, ui or u. So this is the first method, the equilibrium methods. If we are consider here the equilibrium methods, then we are determine the k stiffness matrix. So this is the k stiffness matrix for this bar elements. So this is the k stiffness matrix, basically k equal to the minus k or minus the k or minus k. So this is the under the equilibrium condition how to determine the k stiffness matrix. Now if suppose you want to calculate the displacement function, so how to determine the shape function or the strain displacement matrix, or for in terms of now if I want to use the energy methods for determine the k stiffness matrix, so then using the energy method, the k stiffness matrix are calculated by the volume integration of the b transpose db into dv. So b is the strain displacement relation. So first we should know what is the shape function of that particular bar element. So first we calculate the displacement matrix. So how this equation is come in the bar elements, 1 minus x by l, ui, x by l or uj. So this is the shape function, n1 shape function of bar, this is the n2 shape function of bar. So first we should know how this equation is come. So as you know, the first we have to assume the displacement functions. Suppose I want to calculate the displacement function for the bar. So first I want to calculate the, assume the simple linear displacement function u equal to c1 plus c2x. So this is the linear displacement function. So our basic aim to determine the these constant c1 or c2, that constant. So first I want to assume the displacement function. What type of displacement function I have considered in this bar element. So first we want to, suppose I want to calculate the linear displacement function. So we use this type of function. Now if you want to quadratic displacement function, then one node is also come in center. So that is the another displacement function. You have to assume the quadratic c1 plus c2x plus c2x square. So now if you want to calculate this linear displacement function, because linear displacement function are comes this displacement n1 equal to 1 minus x by l or n2 equal to x by l. So first we should know how these displacement function are comes in this bar problem. So first we include the the boundary condition. Suppose here I am assuming here this is the bar, the x equal to 0, or this is the x equal to L. So now if you are applying all these boundary condition in this equation, equation number third here, so then x equal to 0, x equal to 0, first boundary condition is x equal to 0, what is the displacement ui? X equal to L, what is the displacement uj? So first we apply all these boundary condition in equation number 3. So first is come uj, u x equal to 0. So first boundary condition is x equal to 0, then the displacement is come u equal to ui. So ui equal to the c1 plus c2 into that x equal to 0. So c2, this term is 0, then c1 is come only ui. Now if you are applying the second x equal to L, then u is come to u equal to uj. Now if this boundary condition is put in this equation number 3, then uj is come, it is c1 plus c2 into L. C1 already you know, c1 equal to ui, then ui, so uj minus ui equal to c2 into L. Then C2 is come U2 UJ minus UI divided by L. Divided by L. Now if you substitute these C1 or C2 constant in this equation number 3, then after that you get this set function. N1 equal to 1 minus X by L or N2 equal to X by L. So this is the method scale how to determine the shape function for these simple bar elements, because all these shape function are needed for the mass matrix or damping matrix coefficients. So I have explained here ki how to determine this shape function 1 minus x by l or x by l. Now if you want to calculate the strain, then uj minus ui, the changing displacement with respect to time. So this is the uj minus ui divided by l. Now if you know the strain, then also calculate the stress sigma e, you might multiply the modulus e equal to this strain terms. So after that, you now if you want to calculate the forces, then the sigma equal to force upon area. So then you also calculate the force F equal to AE by L into delta. So this is the K stiffness matrix basically. So what is the K stiffness matrix of bar? So you also know the what is the modulus of that bar material, what is the cross section area, what is the length, then you calculate the stiffness matrix of that bar. So if you want to calculate here the K stiffness matrix, then you use this equation for equation number 7. This is the K stiffness matrix for simple bar elements K minus K or minus KK. This is the AE by L or minus AE by L, you also use here. So this is the K stiffness matrix under the equilibrium conditions. So this is the simple bar case ki how to determine the under the static case the K stiffness matrix. If you want to calculate the strain displacement matrix B matrix, then so you also know the these are the Ni Nj are the shape function 1 minus x by L in terms of zeta. Here the zeta equal to x by L. So if you know the Ni is equal to 1 minus x by L or Nj equal to the Nj equal Nj, this is the nodal points j, the shape function are x by l. If you want to calculate the strain displacement matrix, then epsilon equal to du upon dx. So here the Ni Nj in terms of u displacement function, you also use this equation, equation number 12, and you determine the b into u. So this is the b matrix. If you want to know the how to calculate the K stiffness matrix, here the K stiffness matrix equal to the volume integration B transpose dB into dV. So now if you want to using the here the one dimensional element, so D equal to the E. So B, what is the B stiffness matrix? B is basically, this is the strain displacement matrix. So this is basically, if you know the your N1 or N2 both shape function, then if you have to differentiate with respect to x du upon dx, then you calculate the the B matrix basically. So now if a N1 set function is 1 minus x by L or N2 is equal to x by L, and you calculate the displacement basically B1, so du upon dx basically. So if you want to differentiate with respect to x, then is the B strain displacement matrix is come minus 1 by L or 1 by L. Basically 1 by L. So this is the B matrix. Now if you want to substitute here the B matrix value, then after that you have get the K stiffness matrix. So this is the energy principle ki how to determine the that equations for the K stiffness matrix equal to basically the B transpose E B into B into dV. So this is the here we are using the energy principle, the strain energy due to the stored by bar. So this is the strain energy, simple equation for half into the volume integration stress into strain. So this is the strain energy stored by bar equal to the strain the work done due to the nodal forces. So this is the here we are considered here the two nodal forces Fi or Fj. So depending upon that the force, you have to calculate the work done due to the nodal forces under the the conservation the system, the energy stored by the bar equal to the work done due to the nodal forces. So U equal to W, then you calculate, this is the equation basically. We know the static equation, the KU basically, the F equal to KU. So this is the equation for F equal to K into U. So F is the force vector, here K is the stiffness matrix, that is known as the beta transpose into D in terms of U. This is the displacement matrix. So this is the K stiffness matrix, and after that, if you want to calculate the K stiffness matrix for this using this formula, then you use the B strain displacement matrix. After that, you calculate the AE by L 1 minus 1 minus 1. This is the K stiffness matrix. So if you want to use any types of method, if you want to use the direct equilibrium methods, then also the K stiffness matrix are come same, the K equal to the K minus K minus K K. Here K is equal to the AE by L. If you want to calculate this equation for this energy approach, then you use the shape function. After that, you differentiate with respect to X, and you use here the B matrix, and after that get the K stiffness matrix. So this is the K stiffness matrix for one elements. Now, so under the dynamic case, here we are using the basically principle of virtual work. So under the dynamic condition, the forces are coming due to the, here the forces due to the body force, surface forces or distributed forces. Now under the static case, all these forces are coming in terms of body force, surface force, distributed force. So here we are consider only one force, that is the nodal force. But if you are considered the two-dimensional problem, then surface forces also come, body forces also come due to the weight of that particular problem of particular elements. And this is the inertia force. Inertia force, now if you are considered the dynamic analysis, then the inertia force also come in this problem, the inertia force, this is the dynamic. So this is the basic difference basically. This is the principle of virtual work. The principle of virtual work, the equation of governed by the dynamic response of structure or any medium will be derived from the work of the external force. Work due to the external force to the observed by the work of the internal force, work of inertia and viscous force. So this is the under the energy balance model, your work balance model. So this is the body force, or this is surface force, or this is the distributed force, is equal to the internal force. Internal force, this is the energy we are using here, or this is the inertia force, or this is the dynamic. So this is here the del u is the displacement vector, delta e are the strain, f is the body force, phi here using the surface traction forces. These are the PEI are the distributed forces. So now if you we want to govern for these equation in terms of the mass matrix कि हाउ टू कम द mx, व्हाट इज द डायनेमिक इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन, सो डायनेमिक इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन इज कम mx डबल डॉट प्लस cx डॉट प्लस प्लस kx इक्वल टू ft बेसिकली, सो m into x dot, so this is the inertia force, so that part is come due to the this part, damping force are come this due to this components, and kx are come due to the internal forces, or that this is the ft, ft is the external the force, force due to the body force, or force due to the surface force, or forces due to the this, so this terms are come due to the external forces, so this is the complete governing equation for under the dynamic case. So dynamic case, if we ignore all the inertia force or this damping force, then this equation is come ft equal to ks. This is the static equilibrium equation, the static equation. So now if I want to derive for that the mx, how to come that the basic governing equation mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx equal to ft. So in this case, so first we assume the this is the displacement function. We are assuming here the first, if we are consider the simple bar elements. So this is the displacement equation u equal to, you have calculated the shape function, n is the shape function, d is the displacement vector. So if you here the n1 u1 plus n2 u2. Basically, this is the simple displacement vector equations, n1 u1 plus n2 u2. So here the n1 n2 are the shape function, u1 u2 are the displacement vector. Similarly, if you differentiate here, then this is the velocity terms, u dot equal to n into d dot, or this is the acceleration term, u double dot equal to n into d double dot. So if all these value are substitute in this previous equation, this is the governing the principle of virtual well equation. So here is the u. So you also know the, you know the u displacements. So first you calculate del u, del u equal to n into the delta x, I think delta d basically. So this is the n equal to delta d, or delta u dot equal to n into delta d dot. When you substitute all the value delta u here, the displacement vector, this is the strain. Strain you are also calculate in terms of x. Now if you substitute all these value in this previous equation, then you calculate this is the delta d, because if you are using here, so these all these terms, this is the internal force, this is the inertia force. Inertia force you have to calculate, the this is the density and transpose into n. This, so these terms are come in this equation. Now here, so basically this is the density terms. Now if you want to calculate u double dot, then comes is you know the u equal to, and u equal to basically, here the u equal to n into d, basically n is the shape function, d is the displacement vector. Now if you want to calculate u double dot, then it's come n into d double dot. So this is this term. Now if you want to calculate the delta u transpose, so here is come the n into the d. So after that you have substitute here the del u, the u value and u double dot, you get this equation, the delta, this is the density term. So u double dot is u dot is given the n transpose, n is the shape function. So this is the basically the mass matrix equation. Now similarly, you have substitute the damping terms here, the del u transpose or u dot, the display the velocity vector, then you got this equation, this coefficients, basically kt into n transpose into n. So this is the basically the damping coefficients. If you want to calculate the damping coefficient, then you use the kt into n transpose into n. Or this is the k stiffness mathematics, you already know we have calculated the this equation, the B transpose B into dV. So this is the basically the internal force, this is the inertia force, so this is the mass, this is the velocity component. So that is come the inertia force, this is the damping force, or this is the due to the surface forces, distributed forces, or the internal forces. So this is now, so all these terms here we are denoted here, the external force REXT, this is the internal force that is calculated by the in this equation, this part, this is come K into X basically. So K is come, this is come K into X. So here K is the volume integration B transpose D into B into dV basically. So here the what is the mass matrix? Mass matrix is come volume integration and sigma, this is the density, rho into N transpose and into dV. So this is the inertia terms, or this is the damping terms, basically volume integration of the KD into N transpose into N into dV. So this is the basic governing equation, ki how we have to apply the principle of virtual work, or finally we get the governing equation in terms of mx double dot plus cx dot plus ka. So here if I want to calculate the mass matrix, so how to calculate the mass matrix? Mass matrix is come volume integration of the rho is the density of material, n transpose, n is the shape function, n transpose n into dv. So basically n is the shape function. Now if here we are considered here the bar element, so that shape function n1 equal to 1 minus x by l, or n2 equal to 1 by x by l. So this is the shape function. We have to substitute here the n transpose in n, and after that get the mass matrix. Now if you want to calculate the damping matrix, then c equal to damping matrix is the volume integration kd. Kd is the damping coefficients. Here we have to substitute the n transpose and n1 n2 value, both x minus 1 minus x by l or x by l, or this is the n value, and after that you have to determine the damping coefficient value, the c value, basically the damping matrix. Now this is the internal force, the inertia force we have to calculate, this is such as the kx or k AD. So this is the basically volume integration B transpose into sigma, you have also calculated. Now if you know the B in terms of B matrix dB, so now if you use this equation, then you have to calculate all the equations. And now after that, this is the external force. So what is the external force? So this is the force due to the nodal forces, surface forces, or this is the distributed force. So this is the complete equation of motion. So here the K is the basically the K stiffness matrix, volume integration of the B transpose EB into dV. So this is the complete governing equation, equation number 13.2.1. So this is the governing equation of motion. So after that, if I want to solve the equation, so how to solve this equation? So these are some methods for the free vibration analysis or force vibration analysis. So now if I want to obtain this response of this equation, so for this equation, then we have to calculate all the displacement, velocity, or acceleration. So first we should know. So first we go in this bar elements, ki how to determine that. So I have already discussed in this, ki how to determine the shape function of that equations. Hello. Theek okay. Now, so first we should know how to determine the displacement equation. So first we assume, if we want to assume the linear displacement function, then we have to calculate all these parameters. the first we calculate the the equation for the displacement function. What are the constant of that equation? So first we should calculate. This is the constant A1 or A2 constant value, and after that we calculate the shape function value N1, N2, and after that the calculate the strain displacement equation, the 1 minus L by L, L by L. And when we substitute this, the stress, if I want to calculate the stress, then we substitute the DB or D matrix. First we know what is the one dimension in the D matrix. D is come the E, B is the 1 minus L, 1 by L, U is the, D is the basically the displacement vector. So you have to calculate it, substitute the value U1 or G2 and get the. So first, how to derive the elemental stiffness matrix. So here basically there are the two types of methods are using the determine the mass matrix. One is the lumped mass matrix system, another is the consistent mass matrix. So suppose we are consider here the simple bar element. So here we are assuming the mass of that the bar is total mass of the bar is rho A into L. That is acting so that is acting on the center of gravity, that is the total mass rho a into L. Now if I want to suppose this total mass is distributed for the two nodal points, so this is the external force F1x is the inertia force M1 into the del square d1x into dt square. This is the inertia, the mass into acceleration terms. This is this equation number 16.27 is represent the mass lumped mass matrix. Basically the elements one are acting, this is the mass matrix, the f1x, this is the nodal point one force, so this is the mass matrix for the nodal point one, this is the nodal point two force. So this is the M1 basically, this is the mass matrix rho a l by 2. So that the total mass is divided by the two points the under the lumped mass matrix system. So this is the basically how to give this the lumped mass matrix system, how to get this equation, the mass matrix. So this is the lumped mass matrix equation for the, this is the equation number one, this is equation two. Now if you want to represent in the vector form, so this is the external force, so this is the due to the internal forces, or this is the mass matrix, or this is the inertia force. So this is basically represent the key how to use the what type of system we have to use here, the lumped mass matrix or the consistent mass matrix. So AJ, you know, already use the ANSYS or Abaqus software, so there are some options are available. What type of methods you want to use, the lumped mass matrix or consistent mass matrix? So depending upon that problem, you have to use the lumped mass matrix or consistent mass matrix. So under the consistent mass matrix, you have to use, as you know already, we have to determine the mass matrix equation in terms of volume integration, the rho density and transpose N into dV. So basically this equation is come under the consistent mass matrix. If because now if you have to substitute here the mass matrix, and shape function value 1 minus x by L or x by L, or if multiply, after that you got this equation for basically this is the consistent mass matrix equation, M equal to the volume integration N rho, basically the density of material, and transpose N into dV. Now if you substitute the shape function value, N value 1 minus x by L, or this is the B matrix, and after that you have calculate this mass matrix value rho A 0 to L, or after multiplying you got this equation for this form m equal to basically equation number 16.27. So this is the mass matrix equation. So rho A 0 to L, 1 minus x have a L ka square of after that. Now if you solve this equation, then after that you got this equation. So this is the mass matrix basically rho A L by 6 to 1 1 2. So this is representative. We have considered here the bar. Bar that is the mass is distributed for this form rho A L by basically 3, rho A L by 6, rho A L by 6, or rho A L by 3. So this is the, now if you want if you calculate using the lumped mass matrix, then total mass is acting for the center. We have considered the m by 2 here or m by 2 here. This is the under the lumped mass matrix system. Now if you are if you consider the consistent mass matrix, then mass matrix is distributed for this form. So this is basically the basic governing equation. The Ft, this is the force vector. This is the k-stiffness matrix. Already you know how to calculate the k-stiffness matrix. This is the displacement vector. This is the mass matrix. How to calculate this, the mass matrix using the consistent mass matrix, or you want to calculate the lumped mass matrix. Depending upon the mass matrix equation, you have to calculate the mass matrix. So similarly, first we have to calculate the elemental stiffness matrix, k stiffness matrix for the element, one elements. Suppose here I want to calculate the this is the bar basically. If nodal point one here, nodal point two, if you want to calculate the k stiffness matrix for this this elements, then you have to use for simple k elemental stiffness matrix k minus k minus k or k. If you want to use the mass matrix, then you have to calculate based on this mass matrix equation rho AL by 6, A is the cross section area, L is the length, 2, 1, 1, 2. Suppose if I want to calculate this, this is basically the K is the assembly matrix. If this elements have more than one element, so this is the element 1, element 2. So here the K stiffness matrix for this elements, K1. Or this is the K stiffness matrix for the this elements. Similarly, the mass matrix of this elements, this is the M1 or this is the M2. After that, you have to assemble all these the K stiffness matrix. The now if you want to assemble for here the one nodal point 1, 2, or 3. So first you have to 1, 2, 3. So same manners, you have to use the K stiffness matrix K minus K 0. So this is the minus k, k, or here is here the k, this is the minus k, minus k, or k. So this is the two matrix. Now if you want to use the two elements for one bar element, so this is the global stiffness matrix. Similarly, you have you are also calculate the mass matrix here, assembly the M1, 0. If you want to use the lumped mass matrix, then 0, M2, 0, 0, 0, here M1, or this is the M2. So this is the how to determine the global from the k stiffness matrix or mass matrix. Of course, vector you are k stiffness matrix, you already know. Similar manner, you have to also calculate the global mass matrix. Now, suppose this is the one example, or this is a simple bar. If L is the length made up of the Young model, the material of the Young modular, rho is the density, estimate the natural frequency of this equation. So how to determine using the lumped mass matrix system, how to determine the natural frequency of that particular system. So this is the simple bar matrix here. Using this is the length of L. This is the cross section of area A. E is the modulus of Young modulus of this bar elements. So how to calculate the this equation of first. So first we should know ki how to determine the natural frequency of this particular bar element. So first we determine the governing equation of motion of this bar elements, and after that we have to apply the boundary condition and determine the natural frequency of that system, and after that calculate the motion. So first, now here we are consider that only two nodes here. So this is the simple bar basically. So this is the nodal node number one. This is the node number two. So this is the basically the K stiffness matrix of this bar A E by L 1 -1 -1 -1. This is the displacement U1 or U2. So now if you want to calculate here using the one elements, two elements, or three elements, depending upon that problem, you have to discretize here the this bar element. So now see here are considering the two elements. So this is the first node, first element number one. Another is the this is the element two. So this is the element one. This is the element two. So this is the length of this elements are L, cross section of area A. And after that, you have to calculate the stiffness matrix of this element. So element wise stiffness matrix K is come the A by L. Now if you calculate the total length of this bar is I think L. So this elements is come L by 2. Or this is the another element. So this is the L by 2. So first we calculate the K stiffness matrix for the K1 first element. So A E by L, L by 2. Or this is come 1 -1 -1. So this is the stiffness matrix basically element 1. Now if you want to calculate here the element 2 K stiffness matrix, so K2 equal to A E by basically L by 2. Here the stiffness matrix 1 -1 -1. So this is basically the stiffness matrix. Now if you want to calculate the mass matrix, so then mass matrix is come M1 equal to M1 0 0 M2. So here what is the M1? M1 is come rho A L by 2, basically rho A L by 2. So here is also the M2 matrix. So M equal to the this is the mass matrix. So this is the M1 for the element 1. What is the mass matrix? Another is the M2 is also similar because material is same. So M1 0 or 0. Here, if you calculate in terms of nodal point M1, M2, here you have to use the M2 and M3. But the mass matrix are same, the rho AL by 2, rho AL by 2. Now, after that, you have to assemble all these equations for the element 1 and element 2. Then you have to calculate the AE by L by 2. This is the this terms. Okay, stiffness matrix. This is the first term K1, basically K11, K12. So this is the K11 basically. Or this is the K12. Here K13 is 0 because there is no connectivity nodal point 1, 2, 3. So this is the K13 equal to 0. So this is the stiffness matrix K21. Or this is the K22. So K21 equal to minus 1. So this is the minus 1. Or this is the K22. This is the stiffness matrix. That so what is the if K22 stiffness matrix basically really represent the connectivity of the nodal point 2 and 3. So this is the K22. This is K23. This is the K32. Or this is the K33. So basically the assembly matrix we are used. Here the K equal to the K11, K12, K13, or K21, K22, K23, K31, K32, or K33. So all these value, the value of the K11, K12, you have to substitute in this assembly matrix. So after that, get this equation. So here you have to see the K22 in this matrix is also come. The one here is also the K22 is one. So here the 1 plus 1 is basically one is this is the K22 matrix or this is the K22 matrix for the element 2 or this is the K22 matrix for the elements. So this is the assembly matrix. So this is the K23, K32. So all these value is comes -1, -1. Or this is the K3. So this is the basically the global stiffness matrix. Ki how to determine the global stiffness matrix. So this is the AE by L by 2. This is the coefficients. So this is the U1, U2 are the displacement vector. Or this is the mass matrix value. Rho A L by 2. And this basically this come this is the mass matrix basically. Or this terms is comes how to come this omega I will explain later. Or this is the mass matrix value basically the m by 2 rho a l by 2. So rho a l or this is the 0 0. So after that, so this is the basically the mass matrix equation. This is the displacement vector. Now if you apply what is the boundary condition here, so the boundary condition is here the u1 equal to 0 basically. Or U2 is there is some displacement or U3 also some displacement. So here the first, now if U1 equal to 0, here the U1 equal to 0, then first row or first column you have to eliminate. So this equation is come, now if you eliminate first equation, first row, this is the first row, this is the first column basically. If you eliminate this equation, then it's come 1 plus 1, 2 minus 1, -1, 1. So this is the 2 by 2, this equation after boundary condition. Now, if you want to calculate the, basically this is the K stiffness matrix, as you know, okay, how to determine the natural frequency, omega n equal to the under root K by n, basically. So how, now if you know the omega n square equal to k by n, so this is basically the basic fundamental equation ki how to determine the natural frequency. So as you know, if we are consider here the simple free vibration case mx double dot plus kx equal to ft. Ft here the free vibration case the force is equal to the 0. Now, if here you are assuming the solution x equal to a into sine omega t or cos omega to anything in sine omega t. So now if you substitute here this equation, then this equation is convert the m omega square, basically omega n square plus k. K into a. To the sine omega t basically. So in this equation, this term is sine omega t is not equal to 0. So this term is comes the 0. So then this term basically the minus m omega n square plus k equal to 0. So omega n is come under basically the under root k by m. Okay, so that this is the mass matrix or that term is the previous slide is given here the rho a l by 2 into the omega square. So this is the natural frequency basically terms or this is the K stiffness matrix. So if I want to calculate the natural frequency omega square, then you have to also use the eigenvalue problem or eigenvector problems. Or suppose here this is the equation for the 2AE by L U2 minus U3. So here you have to assume the rho AL by 2 into omega square. This terms, or your first you have to divide this 2AEL, this coefficient is divided in this, is this coefficients. Then this equation is comes from this form. Basically the, here this equation is comes 2 minus 1 minus 1 1 or this terms U2, U3, or here this you have to divide this coefficient divided by in this equations, then this term is comes in terms of in sub coefficient. So here are considering the lambda, or that is come 1 0 0 1 by 2 for this form. So after that you have to, if you have to combine both equation, so then that equation is come for this form 2 minus lambda minus 1 minus 1 1 minus lambda by 2. Here lambda is basically this is the after dividing that coefficient factor. So now if you have to solve this equation, basically this is the 2 by 2 matrix. How to solve this equation? So this is first you have to determinant or calculate this, multiply this, all these diagonal terms, and after that you have to find out the quadratic equation and determine the lambda 1 or lambda 2 value. So this is the lambda 1 basically, or this is the lambda 2. Now if lambda 1 or lambda 2 value you have to substitute in this equation, then you have to get the omega square value. So omega is basically the natural frequency. So you have to determine the natural frequency. So this is the first part, ki how to determine the natural frequency for any of the bar system. The you have to divide in the 2 elements, 3 elements, 4 elements, or what type of displacement function you have to use here. This depends upon the, if you have to calculate the linear if you are initially you have to assume the linear displacement function, then you have to calculate the linear shape function, and after that you have to substitute here and determine the natural frequency. Now if initially you have to assume the quadratic displacement function, depending upon that the displacement function, you have to obtain the natural frequency of that particular system. If you have to use the beam problem, then beam section also, first you have to calculate the displacement function or shape function, or depending upon that the shape function, you have to use the mass matrix equation, the volume integration of the rho, density and transpose and into dv. So only changes occurs due to the shape function. Now if shape function are the beam problem, so then you have to get the mass matrix of beam or truss or any types of what type of you have to problem are using for solving the physical system. This is the how to. Now if you are consider, first we have to use here the lambda mass matrix system and determine the natural frequency omega 1 and omega 2. Now if you want to calculate such as the eigenvectors, mode shape. So how to determine the mode shape? So now, so first we have to, you have to calculate here the displacement value, lambda 1, basically. So now if you know what is the value of omega 1, so omega 1 you have to calculate here, and after the substitute in this equations, you have got the omega 1 with respect to omega 1, you have to determine the lambda 1. A lambda 1 value you have to substitute here. So this is the lambda 1, this is the lambda 1. So according to lambda 1, you have to determine the U2 or U3 value. So this is that is the eigenvalue, or this is the eigenvector. The U2 or U3 are the eigenvector. For that particular frequency, ki what is the shape of that the bar? So you have to determine the U2 or U3. So this is represent the eigenvalue. This is the eigenvector. Similarly, if you have to calculate the omega 2, so after that you have to calculate here the substitute here the omega 2 value, you have to obtain the lambda 2, or lambda 2 value you have to substitute in this equation. So here is come the lambda 2, lambda 2, and determine the U2 or U3. So that displacement function is represent the eigenvector of that second force. So how to solve, how to determine the natural frequency or the mode shape of that particular problem. So this is the we have to calculate in this problem. In table number 6 basically represent ki now if you have to use the single elements, then how the mode shape or the natural frequency are changing here. Okay, now suppose this is the simple bar we are considering here. Now if you are consider here single elements, then the nodal point 1 or nodal point 2. So here this is the basically calculate the element 1 ki what is the mode shape of that particular value. This is the omega 1, this is the omega 2, this is the natural frequency. Now if you are assuming here the two nodes, so you have divide here, so this is the element 1, this is the element 2, so determine the what is the mode shape of this for two elements. This is the three elements, four elements, or this is the basically this is the exact solution of that particular problem, that the bar problem. So how many elements? Basically the main problem is come here, how many elements we have to use for obtain the solution of that particular problem. So suppose if I have used here the element 1, then the value is come around for 1150 to 13, this is the mode shape value. Now if you see here the now if you are considering here the two elements, then also the value is changing here, the 1234 1299 or 290, around this value. So that study known as basically the convergence study. Now suppose if you want to ki koi bhi agar aapka elements hai ki how many elements you have to discretize that particular problem. अगर कोई भी अगर आपकी मान लो सपोज करो एक आपकी बार प्रॉब्लम है, तो उसको मुझे कितने एलिमेंट्स तक उसको डिवाइड करना है. बेसिकली एक एलिमेंट्स में, दो में, चार में, छह में, आठ में, 16 में, 1000 एलिमेंट, तो वो होती है बेसिकली क्या है आपकी कन्वर्जेंस स्टडी. सो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दैट वैल्यू यू हैव टू डिस्क्रिटाइज दैट द पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम. सो हियर यू हैव टू सी how many elements we have to discretize. So here the up to 16 elements he has obtained. This is the mode shape value. So that mode shape value is come based on the exact solution, near to the exact solution basically. So you have to basically compare your results, numerical results, based on the experimental results or the exact, those are exact solution are available in this particular problem. So after that you have to stop the discretizing of that particular problem ki we have to discretize the 100 elements or 16 elements, 32 elements. It depends upon that the okay, what is the exact solution, what is the that particular problem solution. So this is the first problem ki how to determine the basically the frequency and mode shape. So now next problem is the numerical integration, the time integration problem. Okay, now if suppose the force vibration case problem, okay, how to solve that particular force vibration problem. So first we should know, so our governing equation is basically mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx equal to ft. जो हमने स्टडी किया है बेसिकली किया था फ्री वाइब्रेशन एनालिसिस. हियर द एफटी इक्वल टू जीरो. नाउ इफ सपोज आई वांट टू सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन, नाउ हियर फोर्स इज आल्सो वेरिंग विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम, देन हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन. सो दैट इज नोन एज वी हैव टू यूज हियर द न्यूमेरिकल इंटीग्रेशन स्कीम. सो बेसिकली द न्यूमेरिकल इंटीग्रेशन इन टाइम, सो देयर आर बेसिकली द टू टाइप्स ऑफ स्कीम्स or people are using here. The one is the explicit method, another is the implicit method. So generally kya hota hai ki ye jo aapke jo bhi aap software use karte hain, chahe aapka ansys hai ya vicus hai, uske andar aapko sabse pehle first you select what type of method methods, what type of problem you have to solve. Suggest the if you want to solve with the time. Duration are very large. So you want to suggest the impact shock wave problem. The time step is very small. The overall process is completed within the microsecond or millisecond. So you have to use the explicit method. So these are the basic methods ki how to solve that particular problem for the explicit method or implicit method. So explicit method basically is based on the center difference method. So you have to use the center difference method and decide the time step ki how to determine the delta t value. And now if you want to calculate the implicit method, then you have to use the Newmark beta method or Wilson theta method. So these are the basic methods ki how to determine the how to use that the explicit or implicit method. So basically this is the center difference methods ki if you want to calculate the basically the velocity term. So this is the di is represent the velocity coefficient, the di plus 1 minus di minus 1 divided by 2 into delta t. So this is the velocity copy. You have to calculate the velocity term. This is the acceleration. If you want to calculate the acceleration in the each time steps, then you have to the rate of change of velocity with respect to time. You have to calculate the acceleration term. So this equation basically we have to use to perform the center difference methods. So this is the velocity term. So this is the basically the acceleration. The components are using here the 2 into delta t. How this term is come? Because we are here consider the Taylor series expansion. Or based on Taylor series expansion, this the di you have to calculate this di plus 1 minus 2 di into di minus 1 over delta t. So basically, this is the how this terms are calculating. This is the Taylor series expansion. You have to use fx plus h. This Taylor series expansion in terms of x plus h. So this is x minus h. Then after that, you have to put in this equation. Then you have to calculate this acceleration. Recent term basically. So here we are using only up to the second order terms you have to consider here. So now if I want to calculate the di plus 1, so this equation you have to modify 16.3 in this form. The di you want to calculate the di plus 1. Di plus 1 is basically the displacement of next step. So you have to multiply this here, so you have to calculate this equation. So this is the FT equation. The force you have to calculate the how to calculate the FT, the force equation. So that come KD into mass into the acceleration. So K is the basically the stiffness matrix. D is the displacement vector. You also know the initial. What is the initial condition? The displacement equal to zero, velocity equal to zero. Then you have to calculate the basically initial what is the acceleration. So force vector you have already know what type of force are changing. Suppose this force is come from this platform. So what is the initial force value? What is the magnitude of that force? So that is come here. So what is the at a time instance t equal to zero? What is the force value? If force f equal to zero, then you have to calculate the acceleration. So depending upon that the value or problem, you have to calculate the acceleration acceleration. So this is the acceleration is come. You have to modify this equation for this form. The d equal to the ft minus kd divided by m. So m is come the m inverse. So this is the basically the acceleration. You have to calculate this. Now if you know the acceleration, then after that you have to calculate the displacement for the next step. So you So this equation x, the equation 4, 16.34. In this equation, you have to multiply for the mass matrix. Then this equation is come of this form, and after that, you have to this equation you have to convert from this form, or you have to calculate this displacement for the i plus 1 terms, because you know already, you know what is the initial force vector of delta t. You are also know mass matrix, also know delta k d, what is the initial displacement, what is the di minus. So di minus 1 you have to calculate in this. So di minus 1 equal to the initial, what is the initial displacement minus delta t. So this is the velocity term, initial velocity, or this is delta t square, or this is the. To know all these terms, then you have to calculate the next, what is the next term displacement, di plus 1. You know di or di plus 1, then you have to calculate again all these steps. You have to repeat, or you have to calculate. You know what is the displacement of this di plus 1, di minus 1. You also know the delta t, then you have to calculate the velocity term. Or now, if you know the velocity, then after that you have to calculate the acceleration. So this is the basic center difference method. Okay, how to calculate these the mass matrix displacement or that well. Now suppose this is the simple one, simple problem. So I want to calculate the displacement, velocity, acceleration at time 0.05 second interval up to 0.02 second. This is the basically the one-dimensional spring mass oscillator system subjected to the time-dependent force. Now suppose this is the one simple problem, simple spring mass matrix problem, that force Ft, Ft is acting of this point. So how to calculate the basically the displacement of displacement or velocity or acceleration of this particular problem. So first we have to calculate what is the stiffness of this k value, what is the mass matrix. So here mass is also given 31.83 lb/cm² or jo k stiffness matrix. How to calculate the k stiffness matrix? You know already f equal to k into x. You know what is the k is equal to f divided by x or delta x. Delta x here you have to calculate here. So the k stiffness matrix is come around 100. So first we should know how to calculate what are the basic step of this center difference methods. I want to calculate the displacement, velocity, and acceleration. So basically, here we are considering the single degree of freedom associated with mass and the general mass matrix equation. For the describing the equation to reduce the single scalar equation, we will represent here the single degree of freedom system to determine the displacement. So first we have here. Here the step number one, first we have to assume ki what is the initial displacement, t equal to 0, what is the initial displacement and velocity. So we have to initial assume that t equal to 0. So this is the t equal to 0, the initial displacement are 0, or initial jo velocity are also 0. So this is we have to initial assume. If problem is not given, what is the value of the initial time equal to t equal to 0, initial what is that velocity or the displacement you have initially assumed. After that you have to calculate the acceleration. So how to calculate the acceleration t equal to 0 for this equation? So you have to use in the previous equation for this equation, basically this equation. So here the initial force you already know here the initial displacement is 0, so then this comes is 0. So then you have to calculate the initial acceleration equal to the Fi divided by m. Here are calculating here the force in it. What is the initial force value? Is the 2000. You see here, what is this? The P equal to zero. What is the force? This is the 2000 N. So this is the now if I want to calculate the initial acceleration, then F divided by what is the initial force value or what is the mass matrix. So mass here is given in this. So you have to calculate 2000 divided by the mass of the 30.83. So after that you have to calculate this equation to what is the initial acceleration of that particular. If you know the acceleration, then after that you have to calculate the what the step three. You have to calculate the displacement of minus one term. So this is this. You have to use this equation. You have to calculate this di minus one basically. So di minus one. You have to calculate use this equation because you already know what is the initial displacement. Initial displacement is zero. Delta t. You already know what is the initial di value. This is the initial velocity terms. You have already calculated this initial acceleration term. So then you have to calculate I minus one, that displacement value. So this is the di minus one basically calculated in this equation. Now step four, you have to calculate the displacement at time t equal to 0.05 second. Here that the t already is given this problem t equal to the acceleration for the this is the time step basically delta t or what is the total time is 0.2 seconds. So delta t are using here the t equal to the 0.05 seconds. So after that you have to calculate the d1 displacement. So how to calculate the this d1 displacement at? So you have to use this equation for calculation of this di plus one displacement. You have to use this equation because already you know di minus one. You already know, you also know the acceleration. You have to calculate the di plus one. This is the next term displacement. Di minus one means this is the d1. Similarly, you have to calculate the d1, d2. What is the next time step? Here we are consider here the time step t is basically the delta t is the point 0.05. In this problem, you have using the t equal to the 0.05. So next time step is 0.1 because here we are dividing here the four time steps. Is the 0.05, another is 0.1, 0.15, or so. This is the time step in delta t already given in this problem. So you have to use the delta t, and after that you have to calculate the displacement similar manner. The at t equal to 0.1, here t equal to 0.1, the d2 displacement, or again, फिर जो है, you have to calculate the acceleration di d1 into double dot. This is the acceleration. And similarly, you have to calculate all these displacement value for the different time step cases. So this is the final results you have to obtain at a different time step. The t equal to zero, t equal to 0.05, t 0.1, 0.15. 0.2, or depending upon what you have to time step you have chosen here. So this is the forces you have to consider. The t equal to zero, what is the t equal to zero, or like that. This is the you have to obtain your value. Basically, this is the displacement. We are initially assume the displacement are zero. After that, we have to calculate each time step to what is the displacement of delta t 0.05. So this is the time step. This one. Now here the q are calculated. I think this is the q. to, if you have to multiply this, this is the displacement vector. Basically, you have to calculate the spring force. So you have to calculate this is the, I think Q is represented. This is the acceleration. You have to calculate it each time steps. This is the velocity vector. This is the exact. Basically, this is the exact displacement function. So you have to compare your results with the. So this is the methods for we have using here the center difference method for solving the explicit problem. Okay, how to determine the displacement, velocity, and acceleration for different time steps. So this is the basically the exact solution equations. You already know okay, how to use this. So this is the initial force. This is K. Stiffness matrix omega value. Now if you have to substitute here all these value, then you have to obtain this exact solution, exact displacement for the each time steps. So this is, so this was basically the center difference method, how to use for that dynamic problem, how to solve the that governing equation if the force are given for this blast type of loading. This is loading pattern. You have to determine this type of problem using the basically the explicit method, using the center difference method. Now suppose if you want to calculate using the Newmark-Vita method for the implicit problem. Now if time steps is more as compared to the explicit methods, then you have to obtain use for this flowing equation to determine the velocity vector, displacement vector, to determine the basically the velocity component, displacement or acceleration component. So this is the equation for the Newmark equation is given from the DI, the initial velocity vector delta t, or these are the some coefficient lambda 1 or beta here used. So lambda or beta are used for choosing it depending upon what are the values. So the parameter B is generally chosen from 0 to 1 by 4, or lambda is often taken to 1 by 2. Now if here you lambda or beta, if you have chosen here lambda or beta equal to 0, then this equation is converted to the center difference method basically. So now if you have to use in this following value for the beta value is a range of in between the 0 to 1 by 4, then this equation is known as the Newmark equation. So you have to determine the velocity vector or displacement. Now if you have a instance of the choosing the lambda equal to 1 by 2 or beta equal to 0, then the equation 16.39 is reduced to the center difference equation. So for 16.3.1 or 16.3.2. Now if in this equation, if you are choosing here beta equal to 0 or lambda equal to 1 by 2. So this equation is converted to the center difference equation basically. Now here if you are using here the lambda equal to 1 by 2 or beta equal to 1 by 6, then this value corresponding to the linear, basically this is represent the linear acceleration assumptions. If you are assuming this coefficient value in this, then you have to use the linear acceleration assumption. You have to calculate all these the value of the acceleration vector, displacement or velocity vector. Similarly, if lambda equal to 1 by 2 or beta equal to 1 by 4, then you have to obtain numerically analysis are stable. So these coefficients are also represent how to select the this coefficient value for that particular problem, we are assuming the linear acceleration or quadratic acceleration. And so depending upon that coefficients, you have to choose or select this coefficient value for determine the velocity vector, displacement vector, or acceleration vector. If delta t is not given in any type of problem, then you have to assume this approximation. It has been found at the time step approximate the 1/10 of the shortest natural frequency. So first you have to calculate the fundamental natural frequency and divide by 10. You have to select the delta t. How to select the delta t in time steps? Then you have to calculate the time steps. Now, so this is the same the equation governing equation for the if you want to calculate the displacement of ix term. So this is the mass matrix value. This is displacement. You have to use this equation for calculating the next point displacement di plus one. Or now, if you want to calculate here the acceleration, then you have to use this equation to determine the acceleration. You have to substitute here b or lambda value h per requirement. If you want to calculate the linear, then you have to, depending upon the linear requirement, you have to select all these coefficient value. And after that, you have to calculate this force vector depending upon that equation. So here the k, basically k dot is calculated by the k plus 1 upon b delta square into the mass matrix equation. So that equation, basically you have to convert it for the this form. You already know what is the k dash. K dash is k stiffness matrix. You already know what is the k stiffness matrix. If suppose we are using the simple the bar elements, then k stiffness matrix is the volume integration b transpose dv, basically dv into dv. Now if you are using the beam problem, then B stiffness matrix, you have to calculate the B stiffness matrix as per your particular problem. And depending upon that problem, you have to calculate the K stiffness matrix. B, you already know what is that coefficient delta T, what is the time step, M is the mass matrix. So you already know all these terms. So first you have to calculate K dash and F dash, this is the force vector. So what is the next time step? The force value, you have to calculate mass matrix b delta t square. So already all these terms are known, so you have to calculate all these force vector equation. This is the complete procedure for the Newmark equation, how to process for that using the Newmark beta equation. So first you have to assume the time step, the initial, what is the time t equal to 0, what is the displacement, what is the velocity. If a problem is already given, then you have to choose. And if not given, then you have to assume t equal to 0, the displacement are 0 or velocity are 0. After that, you have to use the equation number 16.35. You have to calculate the acceleration. You have to know what is the initial force value, what is the displacement, what is the k stiffness matrix. So you have to calculate the initial acceleration. Equation 16.3.13, you have to determine the displacement d1, or you have to calculate the f i plus 1. Or using this, basically these equations. So you have to calculate the displacement for the using this equation. This is the displacement, this is the next point velocity component, or this is the next point force vector if you want to calculate. So this is the complete flowchart, how to proceed for this particular problem, what type of problem you have to use the bar elements, beam elements, or plate or cell elements, or 3D elements. So depending upon that problem, you have to use, assume the initial displacement value, or delta t value, beta or lambda value. So first you have to calculate initial acceleration value, or you have to repeat all these steps each time interval, you have to calculate the displacement, velocity, or acceleration. Suppose this is the problem for the implicit method, how to solve this particular problem for using the implicit methods. Here the time is the 2 seconds. So in this problem, you have to calculate the displacement, velocity, or acceleration for 2.1 second time increments. So here time increments already given is t equal to 0.1. So depending upon the time steps you have to use to calculate your this particular problem. So here is also given the what is the beta value or lambda value, and after that you have to calculate all these values. So first here already given the what is the mass matrix value. So this is the mass matrix equation. This now so you have to calculate f divided by what is the delta x, so 70. So this is the basically the k-stiffness matrix. This is the mass matrix value, or this is the basically the what is the initial force value. So initial t equal to 0, what is the force value? So here is the t equal to 0, the force ft equal to the 100 lb. So use all these value for solving this equation, this problem, particular problem, using the implicit method, Newmark beta method. So initial here we are assuming that here t equal to 0, what is the displacement and velocity. After that you have to calculate the acceleration value. So here the t equal to 0, that term is 0, so this is the basically the force divided by that the mass. So you have to calculate this is the acceleration, this is the initial force value, this is the k-stiffness matrix, and after that you have to calculate the k dash or f dash or d1 d2, or you have to proceed all these steps as per your time increments, to what time increments you have used t equal to 0.1, 0.2, and you have to determine f2, d2, d3 for that particular one. So this is the basically the time steps t equal to 0. So these are values, you have to determine the displacement, velocity, or acceleration for using the Newmark beta method. So basically in this lecture I have considered how to determine the natural frequency mode shapes and how to solve the Newmark beta, how to use the Newmark beta method to solve the basically the force vibration problem, or the explicit method to solve the wave propagation problem, to determine the displacement, velocity, or acceleration. So Gaurav, can I continue or should I stop?
Yes sir, you can continue. We are having the 15 minute time. That yes, is sir. A gap between.
Now, first is how to determine the natural frequency. See, I have already. The determine natural frequency and mode shape. So, this is the basically the governing equation, that ft equal to kd into md double dot. So, how to determine the natural frequency? So, first, I have already discussed in this key. First, assume the x displacement function a cos omega t or a sin omega t, depending upon that the function you have to calculate the you have to substitute that equation and you have to determine the natural frequency of that particular system. So this is the k minus omega square into m. So this is the basically how to the natural frequency of that particular system. This problem, I think the k-stiffness matrix, how to determine the k-stiffness matrix for the element 1, element 2, and this is the global stiffness matrix. And this is the mass matrix, and this is the assembly matrix. Applying the boundary condition, you have to determine the natural frequency of that particular system. And when you have to substitute, here basically are calculating the mode shape of that particular problem. So first, this determinant equation has solved, then to got the lambda 1, lambda 2, basically the quadratic equation. Now, if you have to determine that the lambda 1 and lambda 2, then you have to substitute in this equation and determine the natural frequency of that omega 1 and omega 2. Now, if you know the lambda 1 and lambda 2 in this equation, you have to substitute again this for the above equation, then you have to determine the mode shape of that particular problem. So these are the basically the mode shape of that particular problem, that particular frequency. What is the omega 1, 1.56? This is the natural frequency of that particular problem. This is the omega 2, is the second natural frequency. And we have to calculate the, after that we have to calculate the mode shape. So mode shape you have to calculate using in this equation, in this form. If you use this equation, basically this equation, so if it 2 mu basically minus lambda minus mu minus lambda y. So here u1 basically u2 or u3. Particular frequency. So now suppose if you want to calculate this mode shape for this particular frequency, lambda 1 equal to 0.60 mu, so you have to substitute here lambda 1 equal to 0.6. And depending on that value of this equation, you have to calculate the u2 or u3 value. So this is u2 or u3 are representing here. Basically, you have to now, if when you have to substitute the all these value, then this basically is come 1.6 into mu minus mu, or this is the mu, or minus here is come the minus lambda 1 upon 2. So lambda 1 is 0.6, 0.3 minus 0.2 mu into u3. So this is basically for two unknowns. So you have to calculate here the u2 or u3 value for equation is come 1.6 u2 minus u3 to. This is the first equation. Another equation for the minus. So these are basically the two equations. After that, here basically I have considered here u2 or this is basically u3. Now if you are assuming here the u3 equal to 1, then in this equation the u basically the u2 is come 1 divided by 1.4. Okay, so you have here, so I think that value is come the 0.7. This represent if u3 equal to 1. So this is represent basically u3 equal to 1. This is a d3 or this is the d2. This is the d3 equal to 1.0, then u2 or d2 is come around 0.7. This is the first, basically that particular frequency omega 1. So these are basically the respective mode shape of this particular frequency. Now if you are assume here the omega 2 equal to 1.85 into that term, your lambda 2 equal to basically 3.41 into mu, you have to substitute here the lambda 2 or lambda 2. After that, you have to got that equation and you have to solve. Then you have to get this type of mode shape basically. So this is the first mode shape. you have to determine. Similarly, you have to solve another problem. If you want to calculate this, that's one is basically wave propagation problem. If Ft is acting of this force is the constant for the 100 lb of this particular problem, so you have to, so basically this is the time dependent problem, one dimensional problem subjected to the force. Boundary condition are given, d1x equal to this, this is the initial boundary condition, or this is the density or this cross section area, modulus of that bar, this is the L of the length of that bar element. So you have to calculate all these value of this particular. Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. For that was really
wonderful talk.
Now, if any questions for audience.
So, dear participants, if you do, you have any query, please ask to sir. I think so, participants do not have any doubt, but definitely you have covered most of the things for the static analysis and dynamic analysis through the route, so they will benefited with it. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, thank you very much, ma'am. So